just to, unfortunately, your experience is not unique, either from the perspective of being trans or from the perspective of getting healthcare in this country. Because we have a broken system, and the way that it shows it's broken is it kills tens of thousands of people every year. When we go in for care, we get sick at the hospital. When we have surgery, things go wrong. We get the wrong kind of medications. And actually, in the United States right now, there really is no oversight of how different surgeries are done, how different protocols of care are followed. So this is something that a lot of people are thinking about, particularly with regard to the health reform effort right now, sort of starting to talk more about patient-centered care, both from the perspective of what is your experience as a patient in the way that the doctor or the provider speaks to you, the way that the atmosphere in the room is, the way that everybody around you is interacting with you, but also from the perspective of what right do you have as a consumer, really, to get a product that isn't going to kill you. And there has been, to date, sort of relatively little, I don't know, maybe the providers know more about this, but some of those, like, rate your doctor is really sort of the sort of most consumer-driven efforts that I've seen. As far as more regulatory or guidance, that's something that is still a long way off. And I would suggest, I mean, the clearest example that I've seen of trans people all of us getting together to talk not only about, you know, best practices, where we go, who's good, who knows what they're doing, who can move forward, but also, you know, the bad jobs list, right? Like, who do you not go to, who is a total disaster, and who doesn't know what they're doing. There was an effort like that, the Trans 411 list in San Francisco, that I don't believe, has anybody worked with Trans 411? I don't believe it's still alive, but I would agree that that is something that we really desperately need, both from the perspective of trans people getting care and from the perspective of all of us as people who are going to end up, for whatever reason, in a healthcare setting and want to make sure that the provider is following some sort of guidance or has sort of a minimum standard of oversight with regard to how they're practicing. I don't know. I am not a provider, so I feel like I'm going to step in.
That's a difficult situation, and I wish I had a clear answer for you. I mean, I really can't say that I know of post-surgery care in the area, and that's unfortunate. Now, by my position at Lincoln Walker with being the patient advocate, I do have a list of outside providers. Obviously, people have the right to choose where they want to go for their health care. So I try to keep a list of providers outside who work with trans folks in a whole host of specialty areas. And I'd be happy to provide you with that. Now, I know post-surgery care is difficult because a lot of us, if we have surgery, we travel for the procedure and then come back home, and then really have a hard time finding that aftercare that we suppose that we need. So, I mean, I'd be happy to provide you with a list of names of doctors that might be able to serve you. But I think it is again an education issue. It's a policy issue. It's a larger issue, and we can see in you like how it really affects us as individuals.
Actually, because for 2013, a lot of the work that I do at Casa Rubio is focusing on education. I am having someone that is going to redesign my website, and I want to focus a lot on my resources. This is also a great opportunity if you and I will want to work together, because there's really no one out there that has actually collected this kind of information, and it does happen very so often. That also includes treatments that are, you know, black market treatments, like selling the wrong hormones, we're selling the wrong silicone, what is going on. And I would be very, very interested in putting something or having something on our website that could provide that information. And I think the way that I'm actually redesigning the website, it could become very, very a good source of information. So I would love to work with you to actually together and maybe a group of people can collect all of this information and put it on our website.
Yeah, I'm into that. Can I help out with that, Ruby? Yeah, sounds good. I guess like the other thing is, so for the last few months, I've been meeting with a couple of lawyers to look at, again, the panoply of insurance options in DC to see, like, you know, how we can get surgeries covered and things like, you know, get the entire spectrum of trans healthcare covered by public and private plans. Because, I mean, once we can get that stuff covered, I would imagine we could get better providers. I mean, it would be easier to assess better providers, get like inpatient care instead of outpatient care and things like that for different surgeries and treatments. So, working on that from a policy angle, and I like this crowdsourcing information on bad doctors idea. I think that should be a major initiative.